Welcome, friends. Welcome to the backyard. I've got a fire going, and I'm going to let that burn down completely to embers because we're going to do a recipe today that I've wanted to do for a very long time. And it is a beef tenderloin crusted with salt and cooked inside of a cloth. So here I have a 100% cotton tea towel, and it's very important that it's 100% cotton. It should be clean, and it shouldn't have any perfume smell or anything like from a dryer sheet or any of that sort of thing. I'm going to put that into this jug and I'm going to soak it in wine. Just enough wine to get it really nice and wet and soaked through. And really let it soak in that wine. You want it sopping wet, fully saturated. Add a little extra wine if you need to. And then we'll move on to this. So this is a Packer beef tenderloin. It's the whole beef tenderloin, and we're gonna have to do a little bit of butchery to it to get it set up and ready to go. So, get it out of the package. Get rid of the package. Now, for this, we really only want the center part. This part down here that is really thin, cut that off because it doesn't cook at the same rate as the rest of the cut. And at this end, there's an ear. And so I'm gonna cut the ear off like that. These two pieces of meat I will grill separately. And then there's this piece of silver skin along the bottom here. We wanna take that off completely. No one likes chewing through that. Now, I ended up cutting the center section in half, and I put the other half in the fridge. I'll cook that at another time. Only Julie and I for supper tonight. I'm gonna spice this. So this is our Montreal steak spice, and I just want to sprinkle some, get it covered on all sides. And I'm just using the tongs because I'm outside and it's easier than having to run and wash my hands every 5 minutes back in the studio. That's pretty good. All sides, get it rubbed in. Now, I'll just set this aside for a moment. And on this tray, we'll lay out our tea towel. And I guess I also needed to mention, you have to sacrifice this tea towel. It's going to burn up in the fire. You'll never get to use it again. Okay, this is take two of this shot because the camera stopped and I didn't notice. What I've done is I've laid a layer of salt, so just fresh salt, all over, and you want the salt to be really, really thick. Then what I did, and this is a recreation, is I put the tenderloin in the middle and then I turned it over so that it becomes crusted with the salt as well. And then you roll it up so that it's completely encrusted in the salt. There we go. That's the way. And then I'm going to fold this in on both sides. Roll it over. And then roll it in. Okay, so the camera shutting down threw me off my game. Be okay. We're getting there. Now, the next thing you need to do is to tie this up really tightly in a bundle. So you get your kitchen twine underneath and tie yourself a knot here at the beginning. Doesn't have to be a pretty knot, just kind of tight. Then you take your butcher twine and you twist it. So now it's twisted like that and you pull that one back about an inch or 2 inches. And you pull it tight. Then you do the same thing. You twist it again, and you come another 2 inches. And you just do that the whole way along the roast until you get to the other end. Now, I've burned this coal bed right down to white hot coals, and we just take the package and nestle it right on top. start a timer in 10 minutes, and in 10 minutes, we'll turn it over. Okay, time to turn it over. And if there's coals stuck to it, don't worry about that. They will continue to cook. And we go another 10 minutes on this side.
Hi friends, I can't stop snacking on these potatoes.
These potatoes, check out the video for these potatoes. But right now, we're here to talk about this.
Your baked tea towel.
My baked tea towel. So we need to unwrap it. It's still got coals on the outside. It's hard. And it might take some doing to get it.
Well, conveniently you poured me some wine. So maybe I'll just, you know, have a little of that while you take care of that.
Okay, friends, this is not going to be pretty. Unwrapping this is not going to be pretty.
Let me know if you need a hand.
It's burnt together. There we go. Okay.
Is that salt?
It is salt, yeah. Now.
I'll take that out of the way for you.
Think, get as much of the salt off the outside as possible. Let's see. Are you ready?
Sure.
So this is done all on time. Everything that I read, every recipe or method for doing this was based on time because you don't know what temperature it is. So
a little longer than perhaps you and I would normally cook it, but
yeah, I would,
that's okay.
I would probably cook it a little bit less.
Got my fork ready.
Let's give it a go.
Just tap a little extra salt off.
Okay, so that just melts. Melts in your mouth. A little bit over salty because I guess I didn't scrape enough of the salt off the outside. I'll know for the rest of this.
But it's got that barbecue house kind of
yeah,
flavor to it.
So I put our Montreal steak spice mix on the outside.
Okay.
But you get that smoky taste directly from the charcoal.
Mm-hmm.
That's just so, so soft.
Mm-hmm.
So soft. Okay, so.
That's really good.
It's really good. Things I think I did wrong. Or things that I could improve on, maybe. I think I used too much salt. It's supposed to be a salt crust and it's supposed to be really hard on the outside. And I think because I put too much salt, it didn't crust
okay.
quite right. Which is maybe why I'm having to scrape the salt off instead of just cracking it open. Off.
That's it? Just the one thing?
I think I did pretty good for the first time.
I did. You made it sound like there was a list. I'm sorry.
Just one thing.
Okay.
So give this a try, and it's going to go really well with those potatoes and the wine that I soaked the tea cloth in.
We are ready.
And the tea towel is never going to be used again. Nope. Thanks for stopping by.
See you again soon.